Welcome, dear friends of Electrical Protection and Control Engineering. In this video, we will show you the pros and cons of overcurrent and differential protection in case of a four-fold power line. What are we going to cover in this video? Basically that. We do it in three steps. We show you the 3S and the evil W, protect the line with directional overcurrent protection, and compare the same configuration with differential protection. And when we are done, we know the pros and cons of protecting power lines with overcurrent and differential protection and blow the bad W up. The 3S of electrical protection engineering are selectivity, speed, and security. Selectivity ensures that only faulty or endangered equipment is switched off and the remaining system parts can continue to be operated. In order to be selective, it makes sense to detect fault location and type of fault using the protection system. Speed leads to a minimization of the extent of damage and danger, and along with selectivity, it's one of the most important requirements. With simple overcurrent protection systems, time compromises are often made in order to implement selective requirements. On the other hand, it is also possible to drop selectivity in order to achieve higher speed and shorter clarification times. Best case is always to combine speed and selectivity. Our third S, the safety of a protection system, describes the ability to perform the required function under special conditions and according to time constraints. In a nutshell, it has to work as expected. If functional deviations occur, we subdivide them in underfunction, overfunction, and total outage. Underfunction would be, for instance, too late distance protection tripping in the wrong zone. Overfunction are unwanted trips, for instance, a differential protection trip under correct operating conditions or when a transformer is switched on. And finally, total outage is total outage. The protection system kind of hibernates. And now it comes. The evil W of protection engineering. It stands for weird economic aspects. The economic adequacy of a protective device to the object to be protected is mandatory. Protecting a 900 MVA block transformer with a fuse from a hardware store is about as effective as trying to change the wind direction with an air pump. Equipping a 100 kVA low voltage transformer with a fully redundant differential protection system can also result in early release from the company's planning department. In practice, however, it often shows that no matter how economically the protective engineer plans, the financial officer knows better. It follows that the evil W is the natural enemy of the 3S, and that's why we're going to blow it up at the end of this video. How can we now protect our power line with overcurrent protection relays? In order to protect the line section between stations A and B, we have to provide a current transformer and an overcurrent protection device at each line end. Since the entire line connects two networks, the short circuit power comes from both directions in case of a fault. It's necessary to carry out directional overcurrent functions and to connect the devices to the respective voltage transformer of the own station. In this way, all line sections are now carried out. We parameterize the last line section with a delay time of 0 seconds. If we assume the circuit breaker has an internal time of approximately 60 milliseconds and guess the relay with 30 milliseconds common time in addition, the theoretical fault clearance time is about 100 milliseconds. The higher ranked relays are now staggered with a time of 300 milliseconds. The time staggering looks like this. 0 milliseconds, 300 milliseconds, 600 milliseconds, and 900 milliseconds. If we take into account the comment and switch intrinsic time, we get a staggered clarification time of 100 milliseconds, 400 milliseconds, 700 milliseconds, and 1 second. And here, we can already see the main disadvantage. While the directional overcurrent protection can be set up easily and without communication connections, it already achieves error clarification times of 1 second with 4 line sections. Further line sections cannot be protected with this concept. In addition, the longest fault clearance times also lie on the line sections close to the feeder, where the greatest short circuit powers are located. Line differential protection endures both selectivity and speed. With line differential protection, each section is protected absolutely selectively with two protective devices. The installation locations of the current transformers determine the protected area. No voltage transformers are required, but additional communication connections between the devices have to be considered. The fault clarification times on each line section are below 100 milliseconds, and theoretically any number of line sections can be protected fast and selectively. The stations themselves are not in the protection area and have to be protected separately, which is done by the busbar differential protection, for instance, or the line differential protection devices are added with overcurrent functions. We have now reached the end of the video. Know that electrical protection systems must be selective, fast and safe. And now we blow up the evil W.